Spinal dysraphism, by definition, spinal dysraphism, various degree of failure of closure of the neural tube, its covering and the posterior neural arch and the skin. Etiology of spinal dysraphism, it can be genetic predisposition plus environmental factors. Some said that canned food can play a role, like meats, peas, ice cream, tea, and some said that the vitamin deficiency and like folic acid can play another role. Spinal dysraphism can be associated with other congenital anomalies of the cardiovascular system, GIT, or other CNS anomaly like hydrocephaly. Incidence and epidemiology, it represents about 0.03 to 2 per 1,000 live births. Embryologically speaking, the closure of a neural tube is completed in the 12th stage, that is day 26 to 30 of gestation. So the critical period in this process is the day 18 to 21. At this time, spinal dysraphism can be developed. واضحة هاي الصورة يمكم؟ هاي الصورة
أي دكتور واضحة؟
الـ classification and pathology of spinal dysraphism. Spinal dysraphism can be what is called occulta or aparta. Occulta means hidden. And aparte means visible or it can be seen at the back of the baby. So spina dysraphism, either occulta or aparte, and aparte can be of different type. It can be either meningocele, that is the protrusion of meninges without neural tissue through the neural arch defect, as in this case, we can see the protrusion defect filled with CSF without neural element, or it can be of meningomyelocele, where the defect contain neural element, maybe spinal cord or nerve roots, or it can be visible to the outside or exposed to the outside, and it can be called myelochiasis, or sometimes there is lipoma with myelomeningocele and called lipomyelomeningocele. These are the four main types of spina bifida aparte. This slide can show us the to the right, this one is if you can see what is called the spina bifida occulta. Outside you can see nothing, but when we do investigation like plain X-ray or CT scan or MRI, we can notice the defect in the neural arch. Diagnosis of spina bifida, it can be done antenatally by analysis of blood and amniotic fluid from the mother and looking for alpha fetal protein at 12 to 14 weeks, or we can diagnose it by high resolution ultrasound at 20 weeks of gestation. Differential diagnosis of spina bifida, it can be confused with sacrococcygeal teratoma or spinal lipoma. Clinical features, we can see by local examination, we can see a lump or a swelling located in the midline, and we can see either in meningocele, we can see intact skin, or abraded or lacerated or ulcerated skin in myelomeningocele, or we can see exposed neural elements at or in case of myelosheathes. We have to examine the baby neurologically by doing examination of the sensation and the power and sphincteric examination. The power of the lower limb, it can be affected, it can be of grade zero, or there is weakness of various grade. Sphincters can be atonic, and the baby with continuous fecal and urine incontinence. It is important to examine the head for presence of hydrocephaly, so we have to do OFC examination or fronto-occipital head circumference measure, and to examine the fontanel. Inshallah, الأمور واضحة, الصوت والصورة واضحة إن شاء الله.
نعم دكتور واضحة.
الحمد لله. Sometimes the spinal bifida associated with musculoskeletal anomalies, like in this picture with the baby with a club foot, and sometimes there is a skin marker at site of spinal bifida, especially with the occulta. We can see a hair, tuft of hair at site of the defect, or we can see hyperpigmentation of the skin surrounding the lesion. Important to assess the lesion radiologically before doing any intervention. We can do plain X-ray to see if there is a defect in the lamina. Better to do spinal MRI, which can delineate the lesion. We can see as the anatomical location and various associated anomalies. Also important to do a CT scan of the spine. In some cases, we can see in this to the left, we can see the spinal canal separated or traversed by bony spar. In this case, you can see the bony spar located at the center of the defect. This is very risky to the neural tissue and of special consideration during surgery. We have to excise this bony spar to avoid future damage of the neural element. In the MRI, we can see clearly the sac in this sagittal view, and we can see the spinal cord and its attachment to the dome of the sac and the CSF content within the sac. واضح الصوت والصورة؟
واضح دكتور.
الحمد لله. Treatment of myelomeningocele, it is a surgical treatment, no rule for conservative, unless in spina bifida occulta, which can be discovered accidentally and causing no sign or symptoms for the patient. So important to excise the sac of the myelo or lipomyelomeningocele or meningocele. If it contains a neural element, we have to release the neural tissue from its attachment to the abnormal skin. As I said, we have to remove of any bony spar inside the spinal canal, plastic repair of the dura to reform the dural or spinal canal, and also plastic repair of the skin overlying the defect. هسه خلصنا السباينا بفيدا الآن إلى الانكفالوسيل. الانكفالوسيل another congenital CSF anomaly. It result from a post-neurulation disorder. It is an outpouching of the meninges, CSF, and dysplastic brain tissue through a defect in the skull, typically covered by dysplastic skin. Content vary from mostly CSF to dysplastic tissue, brain tissue, or rarely functional occipital loop, brainstem or cerebellum. يعني هو بالغالب يحتوي على CSF. مرات يكون ويا functionless brain tissue وكلش رير انه يحتوي على function or functional occipital tissue. ورير كلش انه نلقى بيه brainstem or cerebellum, راح يكون طبعا incompatible with life. الصورة يمكن واضحة, هو الانكفالوسيل it can occur from the nasal bridge to the cranio-cervical junction in the midline, وطبعا يكون لاحظ هنا defect بالskull bone ويا البروتروجين of meninges and neural tissue or brain tissue. Also, according to its location, it can be classified into a basal or sensipetal convexity or occipital according to its location. Basal by sura. شوف اكو protrusion to inside the nasal cavity, هذا الانكفالوسيل. هنا sensipetal ممكن يكون بالvertex نسميه convexity or at the occipit called occipital encephalocele. هذا واضح كلش الاوكسيبيتال انكيفالوسي. Clinical features of encephalocele also depend on the site of the lesion. If it is in the nose, it can cause nasal obstruction or snoring, or in the nasal bridge, it can cause what is called hyperchelorism, which is the wide or widening of the distance between the orbit. بسبب أنه overgrowth or continuous pressure from the encephalocele يسوي لنا separations of the orbit. Evaluation radiologically it can be done by doing the skull x-ray ممكن يشوفنا defect. الأفضل أنه نسوي MRI يعني راح يوضح لنا neural element content within the sac on the CSF. وإذا أردنا يعني better evaluation للبون defect نسوي CT scan راح يوضح لنا البوني defect by requesting a bone window study. هاي الصورة هم small occipital encephalocele. Treatment of encephalocele by excision of the sac, excision of dysplastic neural tissue, plastic repair of the dura, plastic repair of the skin overlying the defect. خلصنا الانكفالوسيل الحمد لله. والآن another congenital anomaly اللي هي craniosynostosis. Etiology unknown. طبعا هو by definition craniosynostosis هو premature closure of the skull suture or cranial sutures. It can be at any site, it can be generalized or separated or individual premature closure, giving various type of craniosynostosis مثل ما تلاحظون بالصور. من يصير premature closure of the suture راح يكون cessation or يعني راح يتوقف النمو of the skull perpendicular to the suture. لأن مثل ما نلاحظ هذا coronal left one closed, فنلاحظ أنه the skull ما راح يصير بيها growth perpendicular to this suture. إذا عندنا الـ sagittal suture closed راح الـ skull ما تنمو in lateral direction, وهكذا كل suture ممكن يعطينا فد feature أو shape معين للـ skull. Accordingly it can be classified according to the morphology in trigonocephaly, brachycephaly, scaphocephaly or ليجوسيفالي. هاي طبعا الأشكال هي الصورة السابقة, كل واحدة هي يعني تمثل شيء معين. ترايغونو يعني يكون مثل المثلث, سكافو هو الكومونست, براكيسيفالي من أوكسيبيتال, والبليجو البايلاترال أوكسيبيتال كلوجر. Etiology can be either primary, it can be simple or complex as a part of another syndrome like Apert syndrome or Crouzen. This is the primary craniosynostosis. Secondary can be secondary to underlying cause such as microcephaly اللي هو يعني retard the growth of the brain, the skull ما راح تنمو, راح يصير بيها premature closure. أو ممكن يكون iatrogenic when we do shunt for hydrocephaly ويقلل intracranial pressure, فراح يصير عندنا premature closure of the sutures. This can be secondary to the shunt surgery. Or it can be due to metabolic cause like rickets, hyperthyroidism, or mucopolysaccharidosis. Diagnosis from the clinical feature, we can see skull deformity. نشوف السوتشر موبيلتي بالنورمال بالاطفال اذا ملاحظين دامين اطفال من when you place on each side of the suture تتحرك السوتشر in such case in craniosynostosis no movement or mobility of the suture. Also we measure the head circumference راح نشوف الهيد اصغر من ال corresponding age ونشوف ridges at the site of suture يكون كلش prominent وممكن يصير عندهم sequent وإذا يعني craniosynostosis growth of the brain راح يسوينا CSF والblood content بمرور الوقت راح يصير عندنا raised intracranial pressure ممكن يصير يعني بابليديما اوبتيك اتروفي بروكتوسيس الفونتانيل طبعا تكون دائما كلوزد بالكرينيو ساينوستوسيس هاي هنا نشوف هاي سكافوسيفالي ليغوسيفالي ترايكونوسيفالي هاي various type of craniosynostosis. Radiologically, we can see the what is called in skull X-ray, thumb print appearance of skull bone due to raised intracranial pressure. فيصير from inside of the skull راح يصير فيها remodeling and thinning of the bones. Due to raised intracranial pressure, ممكن نسوي CT, ممكن MRI to better evaluate the condition. Treatment of craniosynostosis by surgical opening of the fused suture. هي suture closed, فإحنا نرجع نفتحها. By cutting the site of the suture. طبعا العملية my craniosynostosis carries a risk for the baby لأن البون منه مفتحة يصير يعني bleeding, profuse bleeding. هذا bleeding يحتاج blood transfusion. تعرفون بالأطفال blood transfusion ممكن huge volume فممكن يسوي لنا مشاكل اكثر دي اي سي وطبعا هي قد ريسكي سيرجري سام تايمز البيبي دايد اف نوت ويل بريبيرد انفنتايل هيدروسيفالي انذر امبورتنت سبجكت الهيدروسيفالي از ان امبالانس اوف سي اس اف فورميشن and absorption of sufficient magnitude to produce a net accumulation of the fluid within the cerebral ventricles leading to ventriculomegaly and raised intracranial pressure. هنا نلاحظ واحدة من الساينز اكو bulge fontanel another sign هاي ولو مو كلش واضحة الصورة يمكن بس اكو dilated superficial vein هاي two signs بهاي الصورة مع raised intracranial pressure due to hydrocephalus واضحة الصورة والصوت
نعم دكتور
الحمد لله etiology and classification. Hydrocephalus can be communicating or non-communicating. Communicating means no obstruction to the CSF pathway. That is the lesion not in the aqueduct of Sylvius. اللي تحدد أنه this is obstructed or not. Communicating can be of congenital lesion, like Arnold, Chiari malformation, encephalocele, it can be associated with the spinal bifida, or congenital absence of arachnoid granulation where the CSF can be absorbed. Or it can be due to acquired lesion like infection, hemorrhage, and tumors, or oversecretion of CSF like in choroid plexus papilloma. All these conditions will lead to communicating hydrocephalus. Non-communicating, it can be of congenital lesion, most commonly heel aqueduct stenosis, or in condition called Dandy-Walker syndrome, where there will be atresia of the foramen of Lojga and Magendie, اللي هي الفورامين for CSF escape to the from the ventricles from the fourth ventricle to the subarachnoid space. Or it can be benign intracranial cyst, vascular malformation, or non-communicating can be due to acquired lesion like ventricular inflammations or tumors. Infantile hydrocephaly, pathologically speaking, there will be progressive dilatation of the ventricle, as we can see in this coronal view. There will be atrophy of the white matter, axon destruction, secondary demyelination. There will be brain edema. Fibrosis of the choroid plexuses, stretching and denuding of the ependyma, formation of ventricular diverticulae, fenestration of septum pellucidum, thinning and elongation of interhemispheric commissures, or all of these are the pathological changes associated with hydrocephaly. هنا طبعا نلاحظ اكو فد فد ساين مهمة اللي هي هاي sunset eye of the hydrocephaly. Sunset eye تميز ان الهايدرو or large head size due to hydro from another lesion. Sometimes large head size due to tumor or due to subdural hygroma, or it can be familial. All these condition causing no change in the eye sign. But in hydro, we can see sunset eye. We hear downward looking of the eyes. Arnold Chiari malformation associated with hydrocephaly is a developmental abnormality of the brainstem and cerebellar tonsil, medulla, and protrusion of the fourth ventricle into cervical canal below the foramen magnum of a various degree. In anatomy, to our phone, we can see this is the foramen magnum, cranio-cervical junction. هنا طبعا يبدي الattachment of the brainstem with spinal cord or continuity of medulla to the spinal cord. In Arnold Chiari malformation, راح يكون عندنا descent of the medulla, brainstem, and cerebellar tonsil through the foramen magnum to the cervical canal, as demonstrated in this picture. This is the level of the foramen magnum. This is the cervical vertebra, first cervical vertebra. This is the second. This is the third. And this malformation اللي نسميها Arnold Chiari راح ينزل the brain stem والcerebellar tonsil وsometime cerebellum ينزل إلى the spinal canal. طبعا من صير هيج condition راح يسوينا various neurological sign and symptom depending on the degree of the descent. وطبعا هذا أهم يحتاج إلى surgical intervention. هنا تلاحظون مسوين posterior post craniectomy فاتحين الفورامين ماجنم وفاتحين السيرفايكال سباين ونفتح الديورة ونسوي what is called الديورة بلاستي نوسع الديورة فنوسع السبيس where the cerebellar tonsil and brainstem descent خاطر يكون more space ليصير عليهم compression وبعدين يصير ischemia. واضحة الأمور لحد الآن؟ واضح الصوت والصورة؟ ممكن أحد بس يتواصل؟
اي نعم دكتور واضح
الحمد لله خاف ينقطع وما يدري. Infantile hydrocephalus can cause various clinical feature. Striking feature هي head enlargement. Also croc boot sign اللي هي صوت يعني من نطرق على الهيد على السكال يعطينا صوت مثل القوري الخزر. وطبعا ممكن يكون transillumination positive اللي نسوي. Also there will be craniofacial and head body disproportion. البادي يكون small and frail. الانتيريال فونتانير راح تكون وايد bulging tense and non pulsating in severe cases. السكال بتكون thin prominent veins والآي مثل ما حشينا راح يكون عندنا sitting sun sign اللي هي downward looking due to upward gaze palsy. واضحة بهاي الصورة هما الطفل ما يقدر يرفع عينه لفوق يعني اكو pressure على peri-equidectal gray matter due to raised intracranial pressure. أو ممكن يكون عندهم sequent due to third oculomotor palsy. The diagnosis done, it can be done antenatally by ultrasound and postnatally also by doing ultrasound of the head of the baby. شوفنا dilated ventricle. Diagnosis important to do clinical examination. CSF can be give يعني good view in ultrasound and CT and in MRI. We can do CSF examination by tapping the ventricle to see if there is any infection or high protein content, because this will affect the management. Management إذا سوي شانت وهاي CSF protein or infection راح يصير failure of the surgery. Differential diagnosis can be confused with infantile subdural hematoma. طبعا بالCT or MRI we can see various degree of ventricular dilatation with periventricular edema. الآن نشوف lateral ventricles usually dilated with compression of the normal brain tissue وأكو واضحة periventricular edema. Surgical treatment أكو two types of shunt. أكو ventricular arterial shunt سابقا كان كلش يستخدم. Now it is in selected cases can be used. طبعا الventricular arterial shunt ممكن يسوي لنا endocarditis and the blood can be retrograde or backflow to the brain. The most commonly used هو الventriculoperitoneal shunt. الventricle cannulated by the tube, and this tube connected to the device that control the flow of the CSF, and this device connected to the lower end that implanted in the peritoneal cavity, more commonly used. Also carry any complications, can be infected, can be a malfunction, can be breaked, can be kinked or slipped from its side. And ventricular peritoneal shunt indicated for obstructive and communicating hydrocephaly. Acoal endoscopic third ventriculostomy by fenestration of the floor of the third ventricle. نفتح الفورد فنتريكل الفلور مالته على سبراكنويد سبيس by using endoscope and endoscope indicated only for obstructive hydrocephaly. مثل ما ذكرنا shunt be complication, can be infection, obstruction, disconnection, can perforate the bowels or the bladder or the vagina and get to outside. It can cause shunt nephritis by autoimmune stimulation, or a surgery can cause bleeding. Shunt can be slipped to inside the peritoneal cavity or to inside of the ventricles. Another subject, infantile subdural hematoma and hygroma. واضح الأمور عندكم؟ واضح الصوت والصورة؟
يا دكتور واضح.
الحمد لله. Infantile hematoma and hygroma. It can be caused by trauma, by meningitis, and by shunt. ممكن سوينا large head size مثل ما واضحة بالصورة. بس نشوف الآين مالته ما بيها sunset sign اللي هي تفرقنا ياها عن الهيدروسيفالي. هنا الباثولوجي واضح. Bleeding in the subdural space and causing compression of the normal brain tissue. Clinically, the head enlarges. It may cause fits due to raised intracranial pressure, vomiting or repeated vomiting, and failure to thrive. The fontanel it can bulge and tense. ومثل ما ذكرنا, the eyes can normal without sunset sign. This يعني clearly differentiated from hydrocephaly, this sign. الدياغنوسيس أول شيء هو دائما بالدياغنوسيس نذكر الكلينيكال examination, وممكن نسوي brain ultrasound يشوفنا الفلويد or the hematoma content within the subarachnoid العفو subdural space. ممكن نسوي brain CT or brain MRI. فعلى brain CT better بالهيماتوما يشوف لنا, خصوصا بالأكيوت هيماتوما يشوف لنا hyper density of the hematoma. The treatment by doing tapping of the fontanel by needle and aspiration of the hematoma. هنا هاي تلاحظون الفونتانيل واضحة عندكم بالصورة. نتجنب الميدلاين لأن الميدلاين بي superior sagittal sinus, فلازم we go away from midline by 1 to 2 cm and we direct the needle to the cavity and we aspirate by syringe. This is what is called fontanel tap. طبعا هاي fontanel tap indicated for subdural hematoma. And in case of hydro, where the ventricle dilated, we can also tap the ventricle. ذكرناها بالهايدرو نسحب CSF for analysis في نفس الطريقة هاي. أجلت الحكي عنها على مود تكون واضحة عندكم بالصورة. نفس الطريقة بس هنا داخلين بالسبديورال بالدايليتد فنتريكل ممكن نوصل للفنتريكل through the CSF needle and we aspirate the CSF for analysis and also we at the same time we relieve or decrease the intracranial pressure. It can be diagnostic and therapeutic at the same time till the time for the shunt placement. طبعاً in this case infantile subdural hematoma and hygroma ممكن يعني إذا failed the fontanel tap ممكن نخلي shunt and aspirate the fluid. طبعاً الهيماتوما معروفة. الهايغروما يكون not blood but a yellow and thick fluid content. It can be due to, as we said, either a trauma or meningitis. فممكن يسوي لنا هايغروما. واضحة الأمور وما في إن شاء الله أي مشكلة عندكم. احنا يعني الحمد لله خلصنا هاي المحاضرة وان شاء الله يعني نتفق على السب أركينويد هيموريج وش وقت يكون يعني ممثل يتصل بي يكون عندكم وقت ممكن نرتبها بوقت ملائم للجميع إن شاء الله. عندكم أي سؤال أي استفسار؟ سمعوني؟
أي دكتور نسمعك.
ما عندكم أي سؤال؟
لا دكتور إن شاء الله ماكو.
إن شاء الله.